To be honest, there's not a formula I use every time, but I have lived by one rule. Sometimes when someone knocks on your door and gives you an opportunity, you know that you'll never get the call again.
Hey, what's up, everybody? This time on Tribe House TV, I chat with Sydney Tetreault, who's the CEO of Brandless. And Sid is awesome. She's gone through a lot of cool things in her career and learned a lot of life lessons. Here's a little bit of that conversation. Check it out.
I'm Sydney Tetreault. I'm the CEO of Brandless and also the founder and president of the Women Tech Council. Right, most people see me with my business hat, being a community advocate, but I also have a totally adventurous side. When I was 18 years old, I became certified as a scuba diver. I've been diving all over the world. I love that. I will basically take on almost anything from wake surfing to snow skiing to all of those things. Most people don't see me in that vein because they see me in the business context, but adventures, going all in, tackling any city across the country or any adventure, it's just like in it. It's just who I am. And those are the things I love to do the very most. Now, when I think about who I am and this journey that I've been on in the course of my career, I've decided that I think about myself as a storytelling technologist. And the reason I say that is because I look back at the course of my career, it wasn't a straight line. I didn't pick one career when I came out of school. Actually, I would say at every intersection of my career and life, I've never known what I should do next. That has always been a challenge. When you look at my bio, people wouldn't say that, but I felt at every stage this question of, where am I supposed to go spend my time? What am I supposed to do? How do I manage this journey of life and work? So I came out of my undergrad with my computer science degree. And the only thing I knew is I loved innovation, but I wasn't gonna code for the rest of my career. And so it put me into these paths of finding other opportunities. And I stumbled into a place where I not only was able to take a job, which was still in advanced technology, but I got to go to grad school at the same time. And so I went to grad school and I've always had this full willingness to be all in on whatever I'm supposed to be doing at that moment. When I started that journey, it was, I went to school 8 to noon. I did my group study noon to 5 and I worked 6 to 10, 6 days a week in order to get through grad school. But what it did is it put me on a path of being willing to learn, to seek opportunities, and then to find out what I should be. And it took me to really cool places. I got to spend 6 years at Disney, building businesses at Disney, and that completely combined those two paths. It was an unexpected stop. I didn't know even if I was ever going to have a chance, and it wasn't even on my roadmap of things I might potentially have an opportunity to do. One quick story. When I had this opportunity to go to Disney, I had had an amazing colleague of mine, and he's a colleague, probably plays the biggest impact in my career. We have worked together as peers. He's been my boss, I've been his boss, we've been co-founders. Every situation you could imagine, we've actually worked together that way. And he had gone to a new opportunity, been a few years in, and he calls me and he's like, Sid, got this opportunity for you at Disney. We've never hired for this before. We have no idea what this looks like, but you should take it. I fly down, interview, he calls me after and he's like, okay, Sid, here's the deal. You can totally have this job. I cannot tell you if it lasts for 1 month, for 3 months, for 6 months. We've never done it before. We don't know how it will look, but I totally think you should take it. And I thought for 5 seconds and I said, I'm never getting the call again. If I don't say yes, then no one's ever calling me to come work at Disney again. And I've really looked at that through my entire career. What are those moments where someone picks up the phone? I had that experience when Walmart called me to launch a product there. I always say yes. And then along the way, things work out or they don't, or I have to pivot and I'm completely fine with that unknown step into an opportunity that knocks at my door. I think there's two things I would tell any CEO running a corporation. All the other people that you look up to, they also had never done the thing that you're doing for the first time that they did it. So don't be afraid just to go for it and lean all in. And my second piece of advice would be to become an empathetic leader, to be the champion of all the people around you, and to be the person that no matter what happens, they would work for you again.